Survivors ready. Go!
Travis spoken.
This island is pretty much full of only two things. Snakes and rats.
The fake dead grandmother could easily go down as the dirtiest thing ever to be done in this game.
I am the king, and I am back.
Well, I've got the $1 million check written already. I mean, I'm the winner.
The winner of the first Survivor competition is... Rich.
In a row. I'm 57 years old. AARP is going to call up and ask me to represent them.
Bob, still left up there. Bob, a little surprised you were ranked so high by your own tribe and yet nobody's chosen you. Are you a diamond in the rough? Are they missing some gold here?
I think so, but that, you know, time will tell.
Oh, Bob. He's just like the forever Boy Scout.
Go, Bob! Go, Bob. Let's just give him some
moral
support.
Bob, he's totally like, he gets it together. He's got the camp running really smoothly.
Yeah, it's looking really good, man.
He's 57 years old and he's awesome.
Good job, guys. All right.
I've done a lot of stuff around camp. To me, it's common sense. I come from Maine. You know, that's what we do in Maine.
And you know, Elsie, we could actually use a short piece of something.
It's actually turning out to be a nice looking bench.
This is the coolest stuff.
You're the coolest, Bob.
I don't like to spend money on stuff, so I tinker. If I don't know how to do it, I go to the library and get the book, look it up, and go do it. I'm going to make something like this when I get home.
Bob, at what point are we going to eat?
Well, I bet Marcus didn't see that coming.
Well, the next one to go is Bob. So Bob should be worried right now.
I assume I'm toast if we lose another one. If I'm to last, I'm assuming I need to be in a merge. If we're not in a merge, I think I'm history. Even though I teach science. It was a little joke. I'm frustrated. Maybe sugar found the idol. I'm not exactly sure, but I've got to do something. My plan is to make something that looks like an idol. I found something that looked like a skull. So I took the resin that I found in one of the trees, glued the front of it with resin, and then taken knickknacks that I've found around. This is my new fake idol. I potentially have an idol that could threaten somebody else in the tribe. It's sort of like when you're holding up a bank. You don't necessarily need a gun. If they think you got a gun, they might leave you alone.
First vote. Bob. Susie. One vote Bob, one vote Susie. Susie. Two votes, Susie. One vote, Bob. Susie. Three votes, Susie. One vote, Bob. No vote, Sugar. Bob. Three votes, Susie. Two votes, Bob. Bob. We are tied. Three votes, Susie. Three votes, Bob. If this last vote is a vote for Sugar, we have a tie. It is not a vote for Sugar. Let's go in tight on Susie and Bob, the winner of Survivor Gabon. Bob.
Dude, I have not told anybody this, not even on my own tribe, but I am a grandmaster in chess. And have you ever heard of Guillermo Vila before? Have you ever
heard that name? All I've heard of is Bobby Fischer.
Okay, well, Guillermo Vila is an Argentine grandmaster. When I was a kid, I beat him twice. And when you want to talk later, man.
I'm taking orders, bro.
If you want to make the biggest move of this game ever in Survivor, I've got it all laid out.
Actually, I'm not a grandmaster in chess. And the Argentine grandmaster of all time, Guillermo Vilas. He's one of the greatest tennis players of all time, but clearly has nothing to do with chess. So I could pull anything out of the 70s on these guys and they wouldn't know what's going on.
And you know what the beauty is? You don't have to make any decisions.
When Marty said, I am a grandmaster in chess, I'm just thinking, duh, like it makes sense. It does make sense, man. He's always talking about it's a numbers game, and you can see him doing all these numbers in his head, and I'm like, sign me up. It sounds like a good deal, you know?
I would love to go with someone like you to the final three. So what I bring to the table is me, Jill, and Jane. Unless somebody messes her up, but I don't think so. We get four solid people, then we run the show.
I definitely believe what you're saying. It makes sense.
You can never be too cocky. You can never be too confident.
But if I can pull this off,
it could be a whole new ball game.
Thank you, Simon Cobb.
What?
I think we need to get more nervous though. It freaks other people out.
Jamie's such a control freak. He'll come over and say, Rafe, let's go play Guadamancala, which has become his signal for Rafe, I need to talk to you about the game. So I have to play Mancala with him every day.
I have nothing to worry about now, Dan.
I don't know what to tell you, you're constantly asking. He's like, so you're sticking to the six, right? Are you gonna stick with the six? You should stick with the six, right? I'm just worried that everyone's not gonna stick with the six. I'm like, Jamie, I'm sticking with the six. Like, if you ask me again, I'm gonna die. I'm gonna throw these pieces of corn at you. You're driving me insane.
Well, I think everyone here is pretty serious about their work, you know what I mean?
Well, I mean, just gotta reach your own track and I'm good. That would give me peace of mind.
Okay.
Like, you're not voting against me now?
Oh.
Okay. If you ask me again, though, I might.
I'm not kidding. I'm getting nervous. Seriously, I'm so nervous.
Yeah, Jamie,
it's
pretty insane.
So what do you propose to do?
I don't know.
Help me.
What do you propose to do?
You're going with that plan. You know what I'm saying? I don't know what to say.
No, you've asked me 7 times today if I'm still sticking with it.
Well, have you talked to Stan?
Mm-hmm. You need to.
I don't know what to say, you know what I mean? It's a hard decision.
Jamie and I, we've been together since day one, so it's very, very difficult for me to think about voting him off.
I'm in on that, but Gary is a smooth operator.
I think we should do it.
Okay, that's what my heart says,
what
too.
What do you think, Lydia? You guys want Jamie to go, right?
If you do. You know what he did? Eric came to us and he was like, well, y'all four need to report.
He's freaking out.
Why is he freaking out?
He wants all of the girls gone.
I don't trust Eric.
And that's a good instinct.
Here's the thing. Why can't we get him out first?
Well, because there's no way to pull it together.
Here's the
we can ask Kel.
Okay.
Okay, Kel.
What's up?
Okay. She wants to know if
the
people.
Eric, won't be time. Think of it this way. Baloo still has plenty of people. Plenty. I'm telling you, y'all, he is going to wreak havoc.
Kelly and Laura, I just basically let them know that Eric needed to go now. We have four people. They have eight. It's not a big deal if they lose one. I'm definitely putting my faith in Laura and Kelly. And I'm just gonna hope that it works.
Oh my word.
No. Well, I kind of went out for a walk and I stumble upon this rat or this mouse. I'm so scared. Oh my gosh. A rock or a stick. A rock or a stick. I really could. Oh my gosh. I'm like, oh my goodness, that's like something to eat. I was just thinking, I'm starving. I never thought I'd be this hungry in my life. Oh gosh, okay. Just turn around, eat your snack. Eat your snack, buddy. Oh gosh, oh my word. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, this is pitiful. Oh my gosh. Oh Lord, have mercy. Oh my word. Okay. Finally, I just hit the rat. It was really hard for me because he was looking at me. He was cute. But I knew how I'm starving. I've never been this hungry in my entire life. I feel like I'm just fading away. I have something to show y'all.
What do you got?
I killed something, y'all.
Kill?
A rat. I swear. It is, y'all, I swear. It's right here.
What? Ooh.
I know, it's disgusting. Would you have done it?
How'd you kill a rat?
With a stick. It was scary. I didn't know what I was doing. Russell.
Natalie walks into camp with this rat and a coconut. We're all just shocked.
Did you catch that?
I killed it. I hit it with a stick and then the rock.
Are you serious? I just don't know.
Yeah.
She came into this game, the Southern Belle. You know, very sweet, nice girl, but definitely not the rough and tumble survivor type. She wasn't a Shambo. So when she came back in her little bikini with a rat and the coconut, we were all shocked to death.
Yeah. Beef jerky.
Oh, that's so good.
It kind of just tastes like chicken.
On so many levels, I'm proud of Natalie out here. You know, from what I knew about her coming in to where she is now, I think she's changed a lot over the last 23 days, and I'm really happy for her.
Ooh, the rocks are hunter and gatherer.
Oh, thanks.
Please, yo.
First vote. Natalie. That's one for Natalie. Russell. One vote Natalie, one vote Russell. Natalie. Two votes Natalie, one vote Russell. Russell. We're tied. Two votes Natalie, two votes Russell. Natalie. That's three votes Natalie, two votes Russell. Natalie. We're four votes Natalie, two votes Russell. It takes five to win. The winner of Survivor Samoa.
His brother Vetus.
Here it is.
Vetus, tell me about the history of the rivalry. Brothers always rival.
He's afraid of me since he was a little kid.
He's cowering on the inside.
And Aris, what Vetus is bringing up is decades.
Do I feel like I'm seven? A little bit, yeah.
Wow.
Do I want to go in the water? No. I'd like to take the bully and put him in the water, you know?
We are tied 3-3. This is a big matchup. Survivors ready. Go. Aris goes out quickly and Vetus slips. He's on the edge, but he's fighting back. Big matchup. Aris has his older brother down.
All right, well, Aris, you shut that down. We're facing Dawson's boss.
Aris slowly trying to inch his brother off this platform. Vetus not moving.
Fight, fight.
Oh, Aris giving his brother another shot. Start clean. Go on your own call now. Vetus trying to take advantage. One of the biggest unsportsmanlike moves. Aris has Vetus and he's in. Aris defeats his older brother. Takes down the bully. Galong leads 4-3. So Aris, what does that feel like right now?
It feels bad. You know, I love him more than anybody else. He's my brother, and I don't want to fight against him. We've done it enough, but I'm proud I beat him.
I mean, he's a college athlete. I'm the junk. But, you know, I was so happy to go up against him, and I tried my hardest, and he beat my crap for
him. Vetus, it was your brother they took out.
Yeah, I'm really happy that Tina said what she did, because I was feeling it. You know, I mean, you voted out my brother. Like, I'm gonna f*** you up, man. How dare you vote out my little brother? Like, I'm my brother's keeper, and if you do that in this game, like, I'm gonna do the best I can to get you back. But I couldn't say that then. You know, I'm still in this game.
But you just said it.
Well, I'm just saying that's a natural feeling. Everybody has it. But I wanted the feeling to come out first, that, like, hey, I get it. I totally get it.
Jervis, can you relate a little to Vetus?
Of course. I understand his anger, his resentment, all his emotional feelings toward Aris being voted out. When Marissa got out, I told all the Tatahana, I'm throwing salt in your wounds, I'm winning every immunity challenge. That, of course you're gonna feel that way, and I understand that.
And to be honest, Jeff, it's a great move that they made, and I know it's a game about betrayal. You know, everybody's saying Aris had all these alliances. He had a couple. And you know, those people that were intimidated by Aris or myself, you know, blew a little bit of air into that fire. Somebody like Monica, who's already so paranoid out here, she fell for it right away. You know, you just tell her she's a doormat, and she's like, okay, I don't wanna be a doormat, I'm with you, you know, like.
Wow, I've given my word, that's all I have is my integrity out here. I think you flopped on my husband, and my husband's gone. But I stuck my neck out for your brother and for Tina and for the other people in my alliance to get you there to live vicariously through you all.
You were getting yourself further at the same time. Like, this Monica, the benevolent thing is a little bit old. We're all in this thing to win $1 million. We had a bond. When we left Galong, it was like, I'm trusting you and you're trusting me, and you broke that trust.
Circles in all this right now. I get information from Dina and Alex too, which is sort of a precarious position to be in because it could backfire.
Alex is a greater threat only because he's going to make a power play with the girls to get rid of us.
Right.
And I don't want that to happen.
Okay.
And you have more control over the Butch and Matt thing because they can be led in different directions.
Yeah.
To vote for whomever.
Both. Rob is doing his own little work with Matt, and Matt, of course, then will talk with Butch. And so it all kind of, the little fingers are outreaching, and it's all falling into place. Girls are playing their part.
Phew. So, we'll do it.
Do Alex next.
I think so. Dina and Alex both think they have the exact same people to vote the other one off, and both think that their plan is going to work without a hitch. It's like we're in the mob, and that there's going to be a hit on one of my friends, and I really have to look the other way and act like everything's honky-dory. But when we go to tribal council tonight, the one person that's going to get the hit tonight is going to be the person that least expects it.
Because you are a mental and physical powerhouse, you're standing between me and the big prize.
Dina, you couldn't even stick by your word for 3 days. I'd actually love to go up against you in court any day because you're the worst liar I think I've ever met in my life.
Ninth person voted out, the second member of our jury. Dina, that's 5 and that's enough. Need to bring me your torch. No need to read the last vote.
Dina, the tribe has spoken.
Some days I do, some days I don't.
I think they might go for you, Eric, just because you guys look like a couple.
Mm-hmm, I'm sure they will.
Then we have to vote, that's when we cannot split.
Are we going John with her tonight?
That's what I thought.
Yeah.
And Courtney voted for JR last time.
Did she?
Yeah. Courtney and Sharia voted for John with Eric. Frosty voted for Sharia.
Do you think Frosty will be truthful with us?
Now, him and Courtney are really tight. I think somebody's got a little crush. Well, hello, have you seen them, like, cuddling and smiling? That's the only thing that kind of worries me.
There's one last card I could play, which is that I'm pretty sure that James has the immunity idol. So I'm going to try. I'm still going to go talk to them and see. I don't want to go out without a fight, you know.
Either way, tonight, I'm already resigned to going home, okay? But you know that James has a hidden immunity idol? Did you even know that they're in existence?
Yeah, I'm right? Not stupid.
You know, no. I didn't find out until just recently. That's why. I'm not saying because you're stupid, because I guess I was a stupid, okay. I didn't know.
Yeah, anyway.
You don't think this might be a good time to either flush it out or blindside him?
Yeah.
It could be you going home instead of him.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Just hold on. Okay. You just need to not do anything. You just have to trust me, and you just have to not say anything the rest of the day.
Amanda, I can't.
No, nothing. Nothing in your best interest. If you don't, I know you're going home. And just keep it like that.
I came so close to winning immunity again. So it's just a sharp disappointment because I'm next on the chopping block almost for sure. But I think there's a chance that I can turn this around for me. And I think Amanda is my best hope right now for a reprieve.
You did such a great job, kid.
Thank
you. I'm so proud of you.
Thanks.
Yeah, I'm not doing now. Maybe Susie.
Susie?
Yeah.
Yeah? Do you think Susie's gonna be gone tonight?
Everybody. I think Dad's irritating people.
Oh. Maddie and Ace, they're thinking to get rid of Crystal. And it all depends on the pinup girl, Sugar. So, yeah, I will lie in this game. I will do everything in my power to get her to vote with me. Because my life and Crystal's life rests upon her. So basically, this honest to God truth, this is what's happening around camp. I'm not lying to you. And Maddie goes, we're voting out Sugar next immunity challenge. Mm-hmm. And then Crystal's like, okay. So then when Crystal went away, I look at Ace, I'm like, are we really voting out Sugar? And Ace's like, right now Sugar is really good for nothing, except for the hidden immunity idol. They think you're like clueless, you're like a dumb blonde or whatever. Okay? And Ace thinks he has you wrapped around his finger. Like,
okay. I don't trust Kenny. He might have been lying to me, but I've been trusting the biggest snake in the game so far, and I've known that. So I really don't know who to trust at any point in this game.
Ace is like, well, I've actually got the hidden immunity idol from her once. I could probably do that, and then we can blindside her, and then I'll have the hidden immunity idol. And I was like, oh my freaking God, this guy is a snake.
You and I will say we're voting out Crystal.
You vote Ace, I vote Ace, Crystal votes Ace.
Can we blindside Ace?
Blindside Ace, sorry.
And we don't have to worry about the snake ever again.
Never again.
I trust Sugar, and I trust that she will go along with the plan and vote out Ace. She may be the pinup girl, but she's very smart.
Okay, I have a solution. As you know, had a interesting day. I'll go now to take Katie. And I'll give up the million, to get back your guys' friendship.
Wait, you will step down?
Yeah.
Doesn't take you, but instead takes Katie as a way to show that you do care about these guys.
To show that I do, yeah. You would do that? Yep. I would do it.
Just to be clear, Tom has been offering to take you and give you a shot.
Right.
That doesn't sound as good as taking back your integrity and giving up any chance.
That's right.
And giving somebody who's been out of this challenge now for 10 hours.
Yeah, I've thought about for the past 24 hours how to reconcile my differences. Like, my hole gets deeper and deeper. I can't leave this game with that on my shoulder. So I'll dive right now if you take Katie. I said all along the friendship was more important. I feel like the longer we sit up here, the more and more I feel like a traitor to that and a traitor to myself. So, yeah, I'll do it.
Tom, would it be successful? Would he be accomplishing what he's trying to do?
Without a doubt. Ian would have my friendship after this game anyway. But he wins my respect back.
Ian steps down. Tom wins final immunity. Nobody would have predicted this move.
About to fall off too. I'm surprised you did that.
Oh my god!
Put this on.
Let me ask you guys something.
Tom, you have immunity. Is there any reason we shouldn't hold tribal council right now?
I'm going to ask Ian one more time because I think we're both a little punchy and delirious. Are you taking yourself out, and do you want me to hold to that? That
we made a deal. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, you guys need to go to the final two.
All right, here's what's going to happen. The only person who votes is you. Give me a verbal vote. Who are you voting out of this game tonight?
I'm going to vote out my buddy Ian, and as bad as I felt last night, I feel 10 times better. He's just a hell of a guy, and I respect him.
Ian, you are the 16th person voted out of this game. You'll become the 7th member of the jury with potentially a very big vote. So Tom, Katie, you two are the final two. You have one more night here in Palau. Tomorrow night, we will hold our final tribal council. You two will get in your outrigger, head back to the beach. Ian, you'll stay here with me. I'll get you to the jury. Good night.
That was a successful prank call.
I always felt his personality is something Cochran has going for him out here. I mean, when I first came here, I felt kind of bad for Cochran. It seemed like people bullied him. But I can see now why people got annoyed with him. You know, I get frustrated by the kind of air he puts on. I think he's really proud of the move he made. And I think he still thinks that somebody will take him to the end. I don't like it.
Albert's still empty-handed. Ozzy has his third piece. Sophie has her fourth piece of the puzzle. Sophie has her fifth piece of the puzzle. Sophie has her sixth piece of the puzzle. Sophie with her seventh piece. One piece left. Coach turns to watch now. Ozzy still fighting. Sophie wins final immunity!
So close, so far away, yet again.
Sophie, come on over. Sophie, three times individual immunity in this game. This is the biggest. This guarantees you a spot at the final tribal council. You will get a chance to plead your case to the jury as to why you are deserving of the title of sole survivor and the $1 million check. Tonight at Tribal Council, you will have a hand in voting out Ozzy, Coach, or Albert. One of them will become the ninth member of the jury. The other two will join you at the final Tribal Council. I can't wait to see you. Grab your stuff, head back to camp. I'll see you at Tribal Council. But Albert, Coach, and Sophie are, and here we go. First vote. Coach. Sophie. One vote Coach, one vote Sophie.
Whoa.
Coach. Two votes Coach, one vote Sophie. Sophie, we're tied. Two votes Coach, two votes Sophie. Coach. Three votes, Coach. Two votes, Sophie. Sophie. We are tied again. Three votes, Coach. Three votes, Sophie. Sophie. Four votes, Sophie. Three votes, Coach. The winner of Survivor South Pacific, Sophie.
Suri?
Yeah.
You and Suri?
So who would it be?
Well, it would be you, Suri, and us four. And then you wouldn't have to worry about anything for the next 2 weeks.
Think that would be cool? We could definitely try.
That's a load off of her mind for the next 2 weeks.
Terry approached me and just said, here, you and Suri, let's go right now, the six of us. You know, I mean, obviously it's desperation, but I mean, why would we want to join your tribe, homie? We're gonna ride this out and vote you off one at a time. There's no reason to flop. He's grasping at straws, and I get it. I would be doing the same thing.
I talked to Shane already, and our group of four would like to offer you and Shane the opportunity to take the burden of Tribal Council off your shoulders for the next 2 weeks.
Terry tells me that, it was almost laughable. It's like he's offering me something. I don't think he's in a position to offer me anything.
Okay. And if we can solidify this thing, that's even more time of worry-free life around here for the next couple weeks.
Right.
Okay.
All right. Well, I'll get back to you.
All right.
It was like a dictionary salesman. I mean, I already have an encyclopedia collection here, and you want to sell me a dictionary?
I don't even know what you're talking about.
What we talked about over there.
I don't think there's any reason for us to be in anyway.
I know there is. You want to live the next 2 weeks for
a break? Relax for the rest of the day, enjoy myself. If you take a look at where we're at, we're in a really good spot if we just stay where we are, my man. You know, maybe somebody will flop. It's not going to be me, and I know it's not going to be her. I mean, getting to the merge with the numbers is the biggest part of the game, and I just know for me, I'm not flopping, so.
You're trying to sway Shane this morning, and that's not going to happen, not at all. In fact, he didn't even want to talk about it. We're not sure about Suri, and we're not sure about Bruce. So even if we get one person and it's 5-on-5, it could be time to pull out the immunity idol that they don't know about. So could be my ace in the hole for the rest of the game.
This is how I came into this game, to play in stages. Mm-hmm. Like, the first stage was clearly before the mix-up, when it was fans versus favorites, mm-hmm. and just to get through that first couple of votes. And then we have the mix-up. Mm-hmm. So we have to play through this segment to get to the merge. I just feel like I would feel safe if it was you and Alexis, me and James, locked up that four, block mm-hmm. four.
Yeah, I will work with you.
Okay,
I think with James, we can still win immunity.
I think with James, we're fine until the merge. And then once we get to the merge, all of the targets are going to be on the big guys. Like, and we're going to be able to slip under because everyone's going to be so threatened by the big guys trying
Ozzie
to get them out.
James.
Ozzie and James are probably going to be the first to go.
I'm down.
I wouldn't see anything wrong with it being y'all two, me and Amanda, final four.
Yeah, how hot would that be?
You know? I get really unbelievably fourth grade uncomfortable when, like, any guy even remotely makes a move. Like, I'm not the cool girl at all.
Really?
Really?
See, I'm not a
really
girl.
Not cool. I'm not worried about
that. Man. Like,
okay, ladies.
I would love to blindside Jason because he'd be 2-0. The ladies. Just at the jugular, flossing my teeth with his jugular. Either way, it's a win-win. Either Jason goes home, or Jason stays and unearths the idol, or it's James going home. Either way, it's still the five girls down to two guys. Picking them off. One by one.
You know how people always say everything is not perfect? When you get back from a challenge, you find out just how everything is not always perfect.
Okay, business right off the bat. Thank you, David.
At the challenge, there was quite a bit of cockiness with Tammy, Zoe, Big Rob, and John.
I almost was gonna do you because I hated to fit Pasco all the time.
It didn't seem to bother you that much.
Today in the trivia game, Sean went out first, then V, then Kathy. I had some satisfaction that I was the one that cut Sean's last rope, so hopefully that will be an omen tonight.
Everybody saw for their own eyes today at the challenge how arrogant the four was, and I think it rubs people the wrong way.
They just didn't play it smart in that game.
They didn't.
Yeah, they were never going to give us any consideration.
No way.
None.
And the thing is,
I think the way that immunity came down, the coconut chopping and all, I think it signaled us that there was a pecking order and we were included in it, even though we'd been told that that wasn't true.
When we saw the coconuts, they hacked down John's, you know, these, just in the order that they were going to eliminate us. I've been nothing but honest to everybody and following my heart today. I would be lying to my heart and to myself if I went up there and voted for Sean tonight. This is really how I feel, Pasco. If me and you are going to get anywhere towards the end, we have to do this. Well, we would be fools not to. I'm not going to go out fifth or sixth. We've worked
Lawson.
Too hard.
First vote. The Sepia. sepia. Two votes for sepia. Nalia. Two votes for sepia, one vote Nalia. Nalia. Two votes each. Takes four to win. Three votes Nalia, two votes for sepia.
Sepia.
Can't get any tighter. Three votes V. Three votes Nalia. One vote left. The winner of Survivor Marquesas.
For day 30. Head of snakes, I'm so excited.
Hey, good move. I didn't see, nobody saw it coming.
Sorry, dude.
No, that's a great move, man. Travel counts blew up in our face. The way we were expecting it to blindside Sierra, but gosh, it was just, I mean, good move to them. Cat would say touche, and I'm thinking these sons of guns. I hope everybody here likes second place, because if Tyson goes to the end, he's winning. He is playing a hell of a game. Pure poetry. You are playing the best game. Nobody can touch you so much.
Hey. Hold on. Tyson can't do that if it wasn't for me. I told you where he's at if it wasn't
for me. Come on, let him talk.
Let this guy talk, bro. I'm playing this game. I got my hand in his back.
You got your hand on his back. He's pulling
in
the trigger.
His back. He's on my lap.
I'm just saying, Jerv, if you're sitting next to him in the end, he's going to beat you all day. Same with everybody here. I guarantee you.
Hey, why are you throwing me under the bus like that, dude?
I got to do something, dude. Like, it's true, though. Like, it's the flat out the truth. Like, you deserve to win the game.
Because four is better than six. You don't know what type of promises have been made to people, because people at this point start to think about, who can I beat?
Can I say something, Jeff? Monica just said to Sierra, four is better than six, which immediately means, Sierra, you're number four. If you came on this side, there is no four, five, or six. There's one, two, and three, or one, two, and three, however you frame it.
That's incorrect.
What do you mean that's incorrect?
What she has on that side is a backstabber, a liar, a liar.
Okay.
What she has on this side is honest words, people who keep their word, and keep it all together.
Why is the jury laughing?
The jury's laughing because they tried to stab us in the back, and they got played first. That's why they're laughing. Look, man, nobody's entertaining any ideas of jumping ship in this alliance. It's one, two, three, and four. And Hayden, guess what? You're going on the jury. Believe that. You're going to be on the jury.
I'm sure.
The
days where you have nothing to do, it's kind of nice to get away. And I felt like I was a little kid sneaking out from my parents' house again when Eddie and I went to the lagoon. And Eddie's really hot, so I'm like, maybe we're dating. I don't know if this is island dating, I'm not sure. But the more I play up this possible Eddie relationship, the more likely he is to maybe vote for me in the end or give me information.
So what are you thinking?
About what?
I mean, I'll do whatever I need to do, I guess. That's what I'm saying.
I mean, it's...
Well, except vote for Reynolds.
Can you promise?
Promise what?
Will you vote the way I say?
Yeah. What?
Yeah.
I'm not playing you.
Yeah.
Get rid of me, Mike, and Reynolds. You know what I mean? Get rid of the three fans, all right? What's going to happen after that with you? You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. I trust you, but yeah. I don't trust the other people that are with you.
I'm saying I could be an asset to you. That's what I'm saying.
But you won't vote against Reynolds, and you won't vote... Will you vote against Malcolm?
If I have to.
What's troubling to me is I don't think Andrea wants to vote me out. I think that she wants to keep me here. I think that she likes me. And I think that she really does want to drag me along in this game. And I just need to be dragged two or three more votes before I can get up on my own feet and start punching people.
I mean, do you know anything about idols?
No. I really don't.
Honestly?
Nope.
If you can give me information on what Malcolm is suggesting, and just to me, I can at least guarantee that next vote won't be you. And then we can work vote to vote. And I can try to figure out how to sneak you by. I bet for you, if you're in the top three.
Yeah.
I like you.
I don't foresee myself going that far, though, so...
You don't know. I mean, I don't know who goes out here and actually falls for someone. I mean, that's really rare. Like, normally there's an element of you're playing somebody. So I know I'm definitely playing Eddie, but I'm trying to see if he is trying to play me. Okay. Well, I appreciate that you come to me, too.
Even though it's a game, I still only like talking to certain people, you know what I mean? I am indirectly hitting on you.
Couldn't tell.
I came in my heart.
Mm-hmm.
Not before Blake.
Mm-hmm.
And I know you're with him from the beginning.
Well, I feel the same way.
I talked to Papa John. He must vote for Reynolds, Brian.
I think Papa John thinks maybe he thinks we all have an alliance, which we do not. Mm-hmm.
No.
None of us were aligned originally.
Yeah. No. At this point in the game, I know I want good people to go forward.
Yeah.
I want Blake gone first.
Gary came up to me to talk about Blake, and Gary just said he couldn't vote for somebody who just didn't deserve to go any further. And so I said I felt the same way, and I just needed to go talk to the rest of the team.
Gary squares his words with us, you know. And
you've talked to them about it?
I talked to all of them about it, and they all wanted to play just because I think the team community would be better without him.
I'm going to tell you right now, I'm not going to vote for Blake. You know, because we're strong, we got him outed right now. But I'm probably going to vote for, I don't know, Amy or Brian.
Lights come on, Paul. Gives us both a warning for not having proper signaling devices, whistles, and I'm like, dude, we rented these for 2 hours. We don't live here. We live in South downtown Dallas.
You know, the whole Blake situation. We're not sure what's going to happen with that. Everybody's getting a little fed up with him. And I like the guy. He's a good guy. He's just young, and it's just typical frat boy stuff, and I don't like that frat boy stuff at all.
Yeah, girl almost lost my opportunity, too. And so they're together.
But he's really valuable because he's so athletic and he's great in challenges. Brandon and Bobby John said they wouldn't vote for him, and so it kind of comes down to my vote, and I hate being the swing vote. I mean, it's just, that's a part of the game I just don't like. It's because it's going to hurt people's feelings, but it has to happen.
Ready for the next item? Something a little different. Inside this envelope is a huge advantage at the next immunity challenge. Whether or not it is enough to make sure you win depends on how you use it. But if you think you are in trouble, this is worth bidding on.
Hi.
40. 60.
80.
Danny at 80 first.
100. 120. 40.
Steph, 140. Danny, 160.
180. 200.
200 to Danny. Anybody else in this? Going once. Going twice. Sold for 200 to Danny. Here's the deal, Danny. This has a wax seal on it. It needs to remain sealed. We'll deal with it when you get to the next challenge.
Okay.
Woo-hoo. 2 votes Danny, 1 vote Steph. That's 3 votes Danny, 1 vote Steph. It takes 4 votes to win. The winner of Survivor Guatemala.
Supposedly, mentally, I'm supposed to be down, so she's trying to kick me while I'm on the ground.
Yeah, I see it. That's all she's doing.
And you know, a lot of my bravado is just because I'm trying to tell myself, hey, you're still kind of the man.
She knows.
Hey, come on down.
Her only option is to try to get Todd. Me and Steven ain't breaking.
So you really want to send Aaron home tonight?
I was really pissed off. When she went to exile, we were all like patting her on the back. We weren't like trying to kick her because she, you know, I mean, you know, I just thought it was like so tasteless and classless.
JT and I sat down with Coach and we reassured him that Warrior Alliance was good. Aaron was going home tonight. And, you know, JT is going to vote for Aaron because he feels like he promised Coach that he would, but I don't know what I'm going to do. I mean, it's really tricky right now.
She tried to call me out in the very beginning, and I was like, those are the kind of people that get their ass voted out.
Right. Yeah. No one trusts him.
Brendan did it. Tyson started getting sketchy.
Well, Aaron belongs right there beside him.
And you're totally cool with that. I mean, I'm just asking, right? I mean, there's not going to be any surprises tonight, right?
No.
I'm done with the surprises at Tribal, man. Warrior Alliance still going strong. I've surrounded myself with strong players. And to this date, it has not backfired on me. It looks like through all the blind sides, Coach Wade will be the last Tribe member left of what used to be Tempera. I am the last of the Mohicans.
Tally the votes. If anybody has the hidden immunity idol and you want to play it, tonight is the last night you can do so. Okay, once the votes are read, the decision is final. Person voted out will be asked to leave the tribal council area immediately. I'll read the votes. First vote. Coach. Aaron. 1 vote Coach. 1 vote Aaron. Aaron. 2 votes Aaron. 1 vote Coach. Coach. We're tied. 2 votes Coach. 2 votes Aaron. 1 vote left. 12th person voted out, and the 5th member of our jury. Coach, need to bring me your torch.
It was an honor, guys. Thank you.
Coach, the tribe has spoken. Clear, based on the number of blind sides at Tribal Council, this is going to be a really fun finish.
The core alliance is myself, Cassandra, and Yao. But me and Cassandra talked about taking dreams to the top 4. Then we can just
have the core four. That's what they're called, the core four.
Always keep your guard up. You never know when people are trying to trick you. There's a lot of actors here, a lot of poker faces. This is my poker face.
Yeah, so we'll use that line. I think that's the thinnest line, and we'll use these two.
Yeah, there's two more spoofs, there's little lines too.
Okay.
This switch threw a couple of roadblocks into my million, but this game is full of roadblocks. I was counting my million. I had it tight, my plan was tight, but it's changed. It might come full circle if things work out like I want. We'll see.
Hopefully we can have some fish, potatoes, and rice for breakfast. Is that a nice, big, energetic breakfast with some coffee?
This 3-0 moto and 3-0 Ravu on the new team moto that I started. And I know that makes Boo a little nervous. So I know the game is really beginning. They're gonna try to get a swing vote from somebody. But everything's gonna have to go through me. Everything. My plan was always have your friends close and your enemies closer.
Each.
Well, thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome.
Wow, coffee.
This was definitely positive for me in the last camp. I felt as far as alliances, I was on the out. I like Earl a lot. I like Yao Man a lot. You know, I'm a free agent right now. I'm really just going to try to see how the cards fold over the next couple of days.
Cassandra, you think Boo feels nervous?
Oh, very. He had a lot of allies in the other team.
It's a different chemistry and dynamic now, so mm-hmm. You could be a swing vote.
I know.
You could change everything.
Oh, I know.
And Boo could be gone.
I know.
Just like that.
I know.
Just like that.
Mm-hmm.
A word or two here and there in the right situation. You paint the picture the right way.
She could be right on my side. Appreciate you bringing the coffee.
Sure, sure.
Sure,
you guys, keep fishing.
Yeah, I'm trying to do something. It'd be nice to have a little meat.
I have Yao Man. I have Michelle. They're all about the team. All you need is that one vote, and then who has all the power then? That would be me.
First vote. Earl. Second vote. Earl. Two votes, Earl. That's three votes, Earl. Earl. That's four votes, Earl. Earl, you need just one more vote. The winner of Survivor Peih-Gee.
The biggest target right now. I don't want to see my mom go, and the hard part is I don't have the luxury of time.
I just have a lot to tell you, but you have to trust me, and you can't turn on me.
Okay, just tell me.
Do you promise?
Thank you.
Monica is voting my mom. Jervis is voting my mom, and Tyson's voting my mom. and he wants me to vote my mom.
Ties him to for your mom?
Yeah, and he thinks I will because I told him I would.
Still send me out of this mistake.
Did you find it?
Yeah.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I did.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I didn't say that.
Because I know you didn't.
How?
Because I have it.
You found it?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Don't tell anybody. They can't know that we have it.
Stole my idol.
I didn't steal it. I've never been put in this situation before where I really have to lie to somebody like that, but it worked. She just folded her cards right away. I would have stuck it out a lot longer, but she folded. She's like, what? How do you have the idol? Man, you stole it right from out from underneath me. Where was it? And I'm thinking like, well, that was easier than I thought it was gonna be.
What?
It's you.
Really?
Yep. But okay. Katie doesn't have the idol.
How do you know that?
Katie told me. She just told me that. And I believe her.
So do you think
just wondering, we might be able to buy ourselves another week by me telling Tyson Katie doesn't have the idol and getting Katie out.
Why don't we?
So do you want me to go to Tyson and recommend Katie? I thought, why not Katie? We have a good shot at that because I know Katie doesn't have the idol and that's something we can use. So now I'm throwing Katie's name out there to anybody and seeing if anybody will bite at this point.
Okay, once the votes are read, the decision is final. Person voted out will be asked to leave the tribal council area immediately. I'll read the votes. First vote, Laura. Katie. Laura. Laura. That's three votes, Laura. One vote, Katie. Laura. That's four votes, Laura. 11th person voted out of Survivor Blood versus Water. Laura, that's five. That's enough. Need to bring me your torch.
Sorry. I love you.
I'll come back for you.
Have fun.
It's okay.
You have such a good chance to win a meeting. You know that.
I'm just saying.
My heart's still in my chest going like this.
I know, but you know, I'm just saying, I mean, you do. You have a huge shot at putting your name up. I know you're still thinking that, but we do need to solidify three somehow.
Yeah.
I'll make my proposal for me, because that's who I want. I mean, I want to be in that final three. Are you willing to commit at all with me? Or at the very least, make it a tie, so Lisa and I have to make fire.
Well, no, just make a decision. Just go with it. I'm definitely overthinking it, but I won't do this to you for forever because I know I'm just being awful.
I tried to approach Malcolm about going to the final three together, and he's just very hesitant to make any kind of commitment. And so for me, knowing that he had planned so hard to make sure we had a six and had planned so hard to make sure we had a four makes me very leery about his thoughts on keeping me in that final three. So this is kind of scramble time, and I need to figure out a plan and figure it out fast. I haven't gotten the opportunity just to talk to either of you. And so I wanted to feel like you're Michael, because I don't know even where Malcolm's head is. I'm getting like flashbacks to Penner.
Mm-hmm.
Like, Malcolm, are you able to make any commitment for final three? Oh, we've got time, and oh, we don't need to worry about that yet, Jungle Mama. And I'm like, that's all I need to know.
Mm. I'm so glad I'm hearing your dog and I. I thought you were like,
well,
and I thought,
we have been, but strategically, he's got votes all over on the jury.
He does.
He's got the physical play. He's got the social play.
Yeah.
So I think we need to go with Malcolm.
Yeah. Well,
if you guys are on board, that is awesome.
Perfect.
Opening statements. Denise.
Let me start by telling all of you, the one thing I'm not going to do tonight is make any apology for being a part of this final three. I'm not only proud to be here, but I truly feel like I deserve to be here. I've been able to adapt and assimilate not in just one tribe, two tribes, but three tribes. My ability to do that gave me time not only to build initial alliances, but sub-alliances. It gave me time to prove to different tribes that I had value and reason to keep me around as a workhorse at camp and as a value in challenges as a strategic player, I wasn't afraid to make moves that in the end may have upset people and changed the game. At the end of the day, I'm the one sitting up here that has survived every single tribal council, and I'm still sitting here. I've outwit many of you, I've outplayed many of you, and ultimately, I did outlast all of you. And I believe that I deserve the title of Soul Survivor.
First vote, Lisa. Denise. One vote, Lisa. One vote, Denise. Scoopin. One vote, Lisa. One vote, Scoopin. One vote, Denise. Denise. Two votes, Denise. One vote, Lisa. One vote, Scoopin. Denise. Three votes, Denise. One vote, Lisa. One vote, Scoopin. The winner of Survivor Philippines, Denise.
A little bit more about myself. I'm not real good at a balance.
Chris couldn't get across the balance beam. Fact is, he didn't make it, and we lost.
I'll get halfway and hit a wall.
Chris on was fun.
I really wanted to make it across the beam. And you know, if I had wings, I'd have made it. You know, I would have made myself go across the beam. Yeah.
But this game, yeah, without play outlast people, you don't outbalance them.
One of the ideas we come up out there was to try to convince the women that Eliza feels vulnerable, that she doesn't trust her position, that she's unhappy with when she was selected in that challenge, and that possibly she's been talking to us about jumping over with us.
None of us knew what to expect. People from the village looking at us, and we're looking at them, and I'm carrying a pig.
Scout and Twyla are definitely convinced that Julie's the next to go. And then there's me. I'm still weighing my options, but I'm going back and forth like a teeter-totter, you know? I'm thinking one moment, I think I'm going to keep Julie around. And the next moment, you know, I'm thinking maybe I better stick with Twilight Scout.
Yeah.
I'm going to win immunity, guaranteed. That's the prediction. I'll make it right now. Doherty's going to win immunity. It's a fact.
It's like being in a tornado. It is crazy. I don't even have to do something to change the tide of the game. There's six women living with me. They'll change it themselves. It can be set in stone. Who's going home? And 5 minutes later, I'm not going home, and I ain't done a damn thing to change it. I'm just setting it by the fire. So I make my way out to get some wood, and Twyla says to me while we're filling this crate, you know you can change this game completely. So I'm thinking, I'm all ears, Twyla.
You're the only one who can change this.
I'm not going to.
Because right now I'm still in the
I'm
final four.
I'm not going to. You have my word. I'm not going to, Twyla.
I'm telling you, we can change the whole outlook on this.
I'll get to it. Am I willing to do it? Damn right I'm willing to do it. I'll turn the tide. I'll take the risk right now. So I talk to Eliza.
Everybody's scrambling. I just think I'm in a better position than, you know, Twyla Scout, Eliza, or Julie right now. Because I'm pretty much the middleman, as far as I know. You know, what them four have conspired or talked about, I don't know. I don't trust any of them. They're thick as thieves, man. They're all women. How do you trust any of them? So, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm messing with both sides, but it's kind of easy to do right now, and I need to do it to figure out what my best option is right now.
I'm gonna put myself in the best possible situation to win the game. It's tough right now. I'm about to make a decision for long. It's going to be a long afternoon for sure. Just pretty much I'm going to have to put up with three women all afternoon, and that sucks. My alliance is with all three of them, and, you know, they're all bidding for their spot in the final three.
Things have changed. There's dissension in the ranks. The women are not tight.
And the women come across cocky, confident. They have since the merge, since Rory went home. And it got to Scout, the way the other girls were coming across. You know, the cocky way Amy presents herself. Me and Chad, we're doing our best. We're playing it. We're tugging at their hearts. They are rolling in it. Scout, bit. You question a woman's character, you question a woman's ability, she'll snap your neck. You open up your heart, show a woman you're vulnerable, then they start thinking with their heart. That's when they open up that back door. That's what's happened this time.
First vote. Chris. Chris. Two votes, Chris. Twyla. Two votes, Chris. One vote, Twyla. Twyla. We're tied. Two votes, Chris. Two votes, Twyla. Chris. Three votes, Chris. Two votes, Twyla. The winner of Survivor Vanuatu.
Identity now, we've merged into one tribe, but the fact of the matter remains that we're still divided into two tribes, and as Aitutaki came in with fewer numbers, things look pretty bleak.
Rarum. They want to vote for Yule right now. They think he's the mastermind.
Yule is the choice because he's brilliant. He's like Mr. Harvard, Yale, Stanford guy, and he's also really, really strong. So we just want to get him out as quickly as possible.
You don't want Yule for the challenges.
Okay. I mean, I agree. I just...
He's intelligent. I do not want that boy thinking anymore. You know what I'm saying? You don't want that clock ticking there, homie.
You know, I don't really have an option here. I got to figure out something that's going to work, and this might work. We've kind of come up with a desperate plan based on the fact that I have the hidden immunity idol, and it could change, hopefully, the whole flow of the game.
I'm asking you for both of our sakes
to become my ally again.
This is the only chance we got. Everyone recognizes that. This is the only way this is going to work. I thought about it, though. I would want to go to the final two with you, because honestly, I think my chance against you are better than either Becky or Sandra, because they haven't made many enemies, right? You have made enemies.
Yule, so if that's the case, then I too is down in numbers.
The likelihood that all four of us are here at all is very low, but we stuck together and prevailed against the odds. But the fact remains, you know, both tribes are tight. And so we came in at a huge disadvantage, and the odds are still stacked against us. So I don't know what our fate is going to be. I feel like tonight's going to be pivotal.
Tonight, they will decide who they think is most deserving of the title of sole survivor and the $1 million that goes along with it. Yule, opening statement.
I honestly feel that I've probably done more than anyone else to really affect and influence the overall course of this game. I won't lie about the fact that I've had to manipulate and deceive people, but I stayed loyal to the people who are loyal to me. So I would love to get your vote tonight. And I feel like I've earned my way here. I have played every facet of the game and in a way that, you know, I'm proud of. One of the main reasons I wanted to even be on Survivor was the fact that minorities were underrepresented on media. Like when I grew up, I didn't see people look like me on TV. And whenever you see a lot of minorities on TV, it just kind of caricatures. I wanted America to see Asian American men as they truly are. And if I do win this game, you know, I'd want to be a very visible spokesperson for talking about how we can move forward and try to get more minorities represented on TV.
The winner of Survivor Cook Islands.
Kind of just enjoying each other's company and trying to figure everybody out. I'm gonna have a good time doing it, but at the same time, this is a business trip, as I like to say.
Well, I think that's just a natural transition in life. Ladies in the kitchen and the men take care of business and do all the fishing. That resorts back to thousands and thousands of years. Like, it's right here, we're in the jungle, and we're back in the good old days, and it just, they naturally went to their duties, which is cooking and cleaning. And actually, I got some clothes I got to have them wash too. Let me go back and talk to them. Ladies.
I think one of the most important skills, especially out here, is just listening, taking it all in, not saying much. Even when you're hungry as heck, hot as heck, the emotions are high, you gotta remember to keep that character cool. Like Cool Hand Luke. Just keep it cool.
Nothing happened, right?
Long story.
Yeah, nothing, okay.
Long story.
Sorry, she gets a little crazy here.
That's okay.
She kept the clothes on, which I was happy about, but I didn't want everyone to know more about me than they should. It's almost one of those things where I didn't think it was necessary for them to see my family.
The house is a real mess.
Yeah. Why'd you clean up?
What skills come into play at this part of the game? Skating skills. Who's the best skater? Ice skater. Who's got the longest skates on? Who's the best at cutting corners, going around circles? Because usually on skating, you gotta be ice cold. You can't lose your cool. You gotta be like ice. You gotta have friendships, you gotta cut off those friendships. You gotta keep stringing people along and bam, throw them a nice slider. Mr. Freeze is in the house, even though it's about 110 out here. Got my skates on.
Ryan taking a nice leisurely walk to put his 10th step in. Walk on up, Ryan. Nice job. Ryan wins immunity.
Good job, Ryan.
Just like that.
Good job, Ryan.
Good to go, Brian.
Thank you, sir.
You bet.
You're now guaranteed a spot in the Final Four.
Thank you.
Nicely done.
I appreciate that.
Take a moment to enjoy it up here. Celebrate your victory.
When you know where everyone's head's at, it gives you that much more control. It gives you that much more confidence. It gives you a little bit more, a more useful ammunition. I've got three pieces of ammunition I can use. One, I've got my trump card, Jan. Grandma Jan, she's disposable.
Looking good on that black.
Ooh, yeah.
Styling.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. Number two, I've got my loyal and trustworthy soldier, Helen. I know where her head's at. I know how she feels about me. I'm very confident and good feeling about her and her work ethic. My good friend, Uncle Clay. I know what he wants. He knows what I want. I know he doesn't want Helen. I know Helen doesn't want him. When I need to use that against each other, I will. But in the meantime, I'm just sitting back. So there's my three. There's my three ends. One disposable, a loyal soldier, oops, and a good friend.
The winner of Survivor Thailand, Brian.
Yeah.
Yes, it is.
This morning I slept in, was in a good mood, and Courtney comes up and sits down and she's like, we all kind of look at her like, are you okay, Courtney?
Jean Robert could have gone last night.
What?
He could have gone last night.
From the way that I'm playing the game, I need him.
Okay.
From the way you're playing the game, you didn't.
But, like, when I make a point to you guys that, like, this guy does not like me, he's not nice to me, and I don't feel like you stick up for me, I feel like you play, like, okay, well, we need him, so da-da-da, I can't go along with that.
I don't realize that I do that, Courtney, and I would love to stand up for you.
You don't have to even stand, just, like, don't pander to him and say,
okay,
you have a point.
No.
Jean Robert.
You have your opinion about him, and that you don't have to like him.
But I don't say anything to him.
I know you don't.
But he walks around, flowing around like he's the god of everything, and you guys are all like, yeah, yeah, yeah.
We can't have him know that we don't like him, Courtney. We can't, or else he will swap on us.
He's not here. You can say something to me. Like,
Courtney, you are right.
All right, you know what?
It does worry me that Courtney will continue to vote for Jean Robert every single time, because All the other tribe, if there is a merge, needs to know is that one person is voting against Jean Robert, and they will automatically have Jamie, Peih-Gee, and Eric with Courtney voting against Jean Robert, and that's a campaign to get him off, which is losing one of our numbers. Can we patch things up between us instead of having hard feelings like that?
What difference does it make?
It makes a big difference.
It makes a big difference, Courtney.
Obviously, you don't care then. Do you care?
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
What does she want? Like, what does she expect from me? Right now, I need my numbers, and Jean Robert is one of my numbers. Deal with it, bitch.
Todd.
All right, guys. I'm stoked to be here tonight, and you know, first thing I want to say really is thank you for being where you are and helping me to get in this spot in the game. I know that I played a game where I had to lie and I had to backstab and I had to hurt people that I cared about. And the main thing I can ask tonight is that you are able to see the difference between my strategic game and the relations that I actually built with you. Because the relations on a personal level, honest, real. The game level, the strategic level, is what I came here to do. I knew coming into game I was not the most physical, but I knew that I could be the most strategic. And if I did that, I could get here. This is my dream come true. I've lived my dream, and you know, you guys have all been a part of it. And I'm happy to answer whatever questions, hear whatever you have to say about me. I'm ready for it. But I really do want to say thank you for helping me in the game. It means the world to me. So, thanks.
Todd, day one, I went to you. I said, Todd, you know what? You're the schemer here. I know it. I'm on to you. You had the knowledge and you have the smarts. We had a plan to send James home. The best move for all of us at that time was to get rid of James, okay? In my opinion, you organizing to blindside me. Yeah, you blindsided me. Okay, I'm out of the game. But I wasn't the biggest threat.
You started to strategically place ideas in people's heads, which is what I wanted my job to be. And when you had approached me about blindsiding James, I was like, oh no, he's catching up. So who then becomes the biggest threat to me? You. What do I have to do? Turn it around on you, who is an extremely great strategic player in your daily life. I had to get rid of my biggest strategic threat, who is you.
Guys, congratulations. Well done.
That was a good answer.
I shut up.
Isn't that annoying?
James, I'm confused. What are you laughing at?
Because he shut him up. I know.
Honestly,
I'm in awe. He shut his mouth.
I shut
his
mouth.
Todd. We're tied again. Two votes Courtney, two votes Todd, one vote Amanda. Todd. That's three votes Todd, two votes Courtney, one vote Amanda, one vote left. That means, Amanda, you're out of it. You can no longer win. One vote left. This vote will either force a tie between Todd and Courtney, or it will produce a winner. I'll read the last vote. Winner of Survivor China.
I would rather see Sabrina go first before we take Kat out. So Kat's gonna vote Sabrina, and I think Tarzan would be willing to get rid of Sabrina. So it kind of feels like Chelsea and I are the swing votes. Alicia came to me and I told her she's really, really worried that Kat is gonna win. Now she wants to take Kat out next.
Oh my God.
Yeah, she's like, she's gonna win. I don't know that it benefits us.
I start thinking about Sab, and Sab makes me nervous because she's so smart.
All of a sudden, Valicia and I are both thinking on the same page that Kat needs to go. She's selfish and doesn't deserve to be in the final three. But Kim still wants to vote out Sabrina.
I understand where she's coming from, but I feel like Sabrina's been on Kim and I's side since day one.
So you don't think that since she has her mind set on Kat that we should take her out first?
Well, I would say
before she changes her mind.
I'm just trying to make sure that's what we want to do.
Kim and I are going to agree 100% on whatever we decide to do, but I think from here on out, it's going to be a cat fight.
Kim really taking her time, does not want to make a mistake. This would guarantee her a chance to plead her case for the $1 million. She is three steps away. This is it. Portion of this game, and as a result, you are guaranteed a spot, the final tribal council. Two of you are going to go to the final with Kim. One of you will become the final member of the jury that will decide who wins this game. This jury just awarded somebody $1 million. I'm going to read the votes. First vote, Kim. Sabrina, one vote for Sabrina. Kim, two votes Kim, one vote Sabrina. Sabrina, we are tied. Two votes Kim, two votes Sabrina. Kim. Two votes, Sabrina. Kim. That's four votes, Kim. Two votes, Sabrina. The winner of Survivor 1 will. Kim.